Welcome back. Whereas the first quarter of the year in dancehall was almost totally dominated by Carter's trial and conviction. Headlines in this, the last quarter, are being shared among a number of players. The latest being Gully Bop's rise from rags to fame to headline the greatest one-night dancehall show on earth. Here to analyze all of this is the one who Gully Bop called out right here on stage last week.
Long time business. We are talking about them sensation and up. Them freestyle out like candle. We are talking about some new freestyle long.
Well, the ninja is right now on stage to answer. Ninja.
Blessed.
Blessed, sir. So, first of all, just take that. Answer that. Answer for us, Gully Bop, calling you out and saying you are old style, outer style.
The thing is that more and more, when Jamaica people and when them little people here, I go have some respect for them and they reach his prime reach in life. Because, me see, them give Bounty Killer the general, them give Beanie Man the king of dancehall. Warm to Ninja Man, we have been decades in the music. We become the longest reigning DJ in the history of dancehall. The dancehall godfather. The only DJ we have been here and straight to him time, all when they are prisoning and mash up the country. Warm to feel respect. A time for them little leeches and them little take up something here, we fly up, we come from nowhere. Realize I'm not in the corner that they are from. You understand me?
Who specifically?
No, all of them little people we are call up my name. Mm-hmm. Me and them are no size, me and them are no category, me and them are no league.
Even Gully Bop?
Gully Bop, no, none of them.
Friend?
I didn't rise from a telephone bus. I rise from a dancehall bus. I come here, battle with dancehall. But I want to tell you something, you know. Mm-hmm. Gully Bop don't bust the cars in bad people. Gully Bop bus come from a clowning thing, you know. I take him for you that on the video and I go and people see it and we get likes and start beautiful because he look good and sound good in the way I go on, you know. Him not really bust because he mash up nowhere, you know. Where Gully Bop fi do fi know say him is an old DJ where did wreck him life and chat down in the gully and him see which point fi come out now. If he does come out, fix back in teeth, deal in career, and do something good for him mother when he say he want help. Don't try with Ninja Man. Cause I have one thing to tell you, anytime you put it on, and no Gucci and no Louis Vuitton, this is something I make your body full of corn. I make your favor run a Roger Clark farm. Listen this, me say, the boy go for gun, so me go for mine. Both him I go dopey me, most in I mine. Me not a blow storm, like you take every nine, everybody disappear, like imaginary line, no walk with me, walk. Ninja Man black and ugly and dark, park to Geeta Park, run to One Town Park. When me walk yellow tape and crowd up and chart news flash broadcast. Oh, anytime we put it on, don't play me.
What them do? They wake you up, Ninja.
Don't play me.
You, this whole thing, this Gully Bop thing, wake you up?
No, it don't wake me up.
Yeah.
Because there is nowhere.
You were sleeping.
No DJ in the east of Jamaica can get me upon a stage. The hunger man with me. The two DJ if you come clash me because the heights where me reach in a killing thing, lyrically upon stage. The only two DJ have come up under my wing, mm-hmm. where don't get dead, is Beanie Man and Bounty Killer. None of them have reached the heights where Beanie and Bounty reach. And I always kill the baddest of the baddest DJ. I never kill no DJ where rise up to the and call him name. I kill a DJ where rise and straight through the ear my the artist thing so people prepare for that word.
So will you take out?
Take out
Gully Bop.
Take out Gully Bop. Hmm. You're not a man that's not a respect me than a Winford. You're bright and fierce, you know. Gully Bop can't come and with me. Let me tell you something. Leng. Oh, yeah. And the whole of Supreme Promotion, we are bright. Let me tell you something. Gully Bop, Leng, and the whole of them. Yeah. Them not have no manners. You understand?
Okay.
And if I didn't get my money already, if you got perform, not for them clash. If I didn't get the money already, if you got perform. And if I hear one more argument about me and the local people, I got clash. I got to just carry the money, go through it straight to Mr. Leng office. And if him ramp, I carry come on CBM TV, come here on the next week, and on stage. So listen, Mr. Leng, your money is a small amount. It cannot even, you can't hold on my car chunk. It's up now, like a part where, you know, I'm calling and put me like a garbage thing. That money, they don't good. I don't need it. So I can't give it back to you. I'm the working thing because of the love of the people there. Don't bribe to my career.
Okay.
I'm not DJing for no like a normal thing, you know. I'm DJing for society. I'm going out for the wider scale of people. Mm. Me graduate from dancehall carelessness. I'm going out to which part? Me I look towards a bigger thing. Listen to the song that me are doing. You listen Jamaica Town. You listen Ninja Me Ninja. You listen to the type of song that me are dealing right now. Me not dealing no careless song. Me not no war thing with nobody. Me are dealing a career. If you are dealing with something. Now, when I kill DJ before him dead, it make news headline. When I kill Gully Bapa, if you walk around with him picture and say, I'm just kill everybody last time people happen. And who him gargan and where him come from?
Okay, sir. So let's talk about Aishana. You were featured in that scandal, that Futai Aishana scandal. As a coach, you were called a coach in that
scandal. You ever see me from football field?
No.
You ever see me in another sport? So when me turn coach?
Well, you could be a family coach.
For what?
A life coach.
For what?
For relationships that have gone sour.
Me look like the pastor to you?
Mm-hmm. Okay, then. So you weren't coaching Aishana?
For what? Mm-hmm. Was I with Aishana, anybody in our bed? Why me should I be a coach for you when they're in a them problem? That is not a part of my business.
Okay, sir.
That is not my concern. It's not my responsibility. It's one thing I have to tell all these young ads and them people nowadays. It's time for you to put back on a life in our house, in our bedroom, and in our yard, and take it off of the internet. Stop making a personal life and a private life becomes a public issue. Nowadays, if two artists have a problem, them go up on the internet. Them not try reason it out and done it right here, so.
Okay.
Them go up on the internet and them share a thing when they have careless views because there are some people that is visit up the internet, them just careless. Them now have nothing to do more than listen to people things and watch people things and then gain them views and them start passing remarks. These are nothing but set up hypocritical mockers who sit down and do nothing more than live in a people business.
Okay.
Me no too in a them thing that we see the artists, them a clown out themselves and make themselves be a set of stupid people because your life is your life. Your private life is your private life. You see, understand? So leave that in your house and make your public life go out the road.
All right. Being a bounty peace, newfound peace. Well, seems to be lasting now.
Well, listen up. Mm-hmm. This is something with the music business. Last for a long time. And I'm so glad. My little brother see him the Capitan. From day one, we have sparred from so. And you never hear say Ninja Man and Capitan have no vibes and no this and no that and no dispute that we can't reason about. If a little thing go on, we talk it out and we done and we balance back. These are the type of chain where artists supposed to run with. Because if me have a problem, it's supposed to can go take profit, you know. If me have a bill of lyrics and something not right in them, it's supposed to can go take profit. Hear this. See where you can put now this. And him supposed to can patch up the part there. Likewise, the prophet of a song I want me to finish it. Me can't finish it too. You understand? Okay. Because my first hit song with me make is prophet make it. You understand? And we never forget that until the day I did. I never forget that.
So it's a good thing.
So the Beanie greatest thing is to know that Beanie and Bounty is now powering, doing song together. You understand me? And it share a different light to the music fraternity and them younger artists. You know, first to say, unity in the business and the strength of Bill Boxer. From one thing lead to another, only hope the negativity that comes around anymore.
Mm-hmm. It is widely believed that Cartel is still running the place from behind bars. Do you agree?
Listen, Cartel is doing well from behind bars. And I'm glad, you know why I'm glad? I hear enough artists out here before the man gets sentenced. Them say, they want to go to prison because for them career go better. And all of whom I hear say so, I don't hear them have a hit song. And I hear Cartel about 4 and 5 it song. So you see me? Me love when you try to put your use a bad mouth and bad minded and do pee and chat some way against people. God sure say no, you are the man. Whatsoever reach Cartel, God have his own plan and his own decision and what he might do towards mankind. Because you can't do nothing to yourself, you know. God deal with all things, you know. When good come to you and evil come to you, you know. And God deal with it, you know. Because if God no want to evil reach you, he can't reach you, you know. So he might allow certain things to happen to you at times to make you know, say. Look into yourself and know what you are doing, you know. You understand me? So God have him decisions where him have to do and him plan where him have to do. No man is supposed to take up that pan in head and want to tell him say the man fi steer so because of way. Only man supposed to say them have any indicted feelings against Cartel is me. And Cartel disrespect me and I apologize. And there's no indicted feelings with me and Cartel.
Okay.
You understand me? So some man we are chat bad mind, me love all the youth still there jail and him still a triumphant over enough of them.
Okay?
You understand?
All right. It seems like a number of now new arrivals, young artists in dancehall, are ganging up against one, Alkaline, based on the amount of calls we have
all
heard
right,
to come to Sting and Clash. Give us your views on that.
Him better don't go over there.
Why you say that?
If he go over there and go by the stage, no clash. Mm. At the last of Alkaline. So, a quarter time left in the car, when go out there, some press make check what time the bunks have done there, you know, because I'm tell you something. If you don't go to some press and do it, you know, you better can't do it with thing, you know. It's problem you reach now. And them call him out now for a war when, and him say more going out, which me know him can't win. No war out there. I mean, I ask.
So who will take him out?
Eh? Right now, if you go near Tamil, you have no more life. Mm. And if you go more near Prime Minister, me, I tell you something. He might have a problem.
Yes, that's
and what, even Gates, you go give him
that
problem.
That is the dark horse in this race, Prime Minister from the West.
Yeah.
His name is not featured a lot in there, but he's quite a lyricist.
He's a good artist.
Yeah.
Me listen to him on Mobile.
Yeah, he's a very good artist.
Me, I listened to him last night, but he never so powerful last night, but I'm going to tell you something.
So, what about Massacre? What did you say about Gage?
Gage, our next one, we think they have to watch too, man.
Alkaline.
Yeah,
so what about Massacre?
Well, to what size me hear about Massacre, you know. That name there alone, you have to watch it, you know.
That name alone,
watch it. And are you, they are spitfire too?
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
For sure.
So you have to be careful.
But here's how I read it, Ninja. I consider Alkaline, based on a number of things that we have done and researched, is the front runner in that little group. In terms of name ID, in terms of who people are talking about and researching and listening to. And he has a few songs out there in the space at this time.
Yeah, but
don't you think that if he doesn't go to Sting and take on all of this, because already, you know, he's the underdog, because everybody want him, to take him out.
No, man, I'm not saying you're underdog, man.
Why not? Everybody will call him out and I say him coward, him for come. So, but if he doesn't go to Sting and take them on, right, if he just admits him and go Sting, you know, that alone makes him, probably win the clash already.
By just
walking into the fire. But let me finish my thought. If you don't go, if he doesn't go, next year, whoever emerges from this group will probably be the front runner. The new front runner without a clash with him.
So I'm going to tell you something now.
Yes.
You think your name Ninja, man? Mm. Him don't have a credibility of war.
Yes.
Sting is a battlefield. You don't have to go out in a war if you don't have a title for war.
So, but you can't go and do the war too.
Cape Town never go a Sting a war yet.
Yes, so a man no must have a war.
So, and Cape Town never flap a Sting yet. Mm. So, him not have to go out on a war. Anybody call you and have to go.
But him can go and do the show for the people.
You can do your show.
Yes, and because where he's poised right now, I think that is exactly to take out, to erase totally. The negatives of Sunfest and Dream Weekend and all these things.
In a short word.
Sting could bring him back, don't you think?
Bring back? Some bomb the man have to chew up on him over there. He better be here. You mean? Tell us in the pile dance, an interference. It's not my business. We say, mother, we call out Alkaline for war. Them have reason to kill him.
Okay.
Them have reason to kill him. Them don't want to kill Alkaline because of his lyrical.
So, nigga, if you were him, you wouldn't go?
Where?
You wouldn't walk out?
Remember, say me, I know the type of DJ where DJ foolishness, you know, and madness, you know, and nastiness, you know. Me DJ about war. So, for you say war, me a war. Before me resign from war, nobody can call me name. All the year, who are hype up and call me name. But then, when me resign, and when me resign, the next competition after me resign, $3 million for Kipris lose swim belt, you know. If Brock Ryan get the belt from Kipris, it costs $3 million. So how much it will cost me take back my belt, 26 years of championship, to bring it back in a Jam World?
Yes.
under $10 million, then can't get me in there. Then can't get me in there unless and them put me against Bounty Killer, Beanie Man. Because them, they are the only two DJ were in the category and the class where me for deal with killing. And Bounty Killer will not clash me because he's my son. Mm-hmm. And we passed that stage already of thinking about clashing each other. Beanie Man, he's my son too. And him decides, any old war I go on, he's Beanie Man a general. Him trick the people, man, turn it not friendly. So you know, God, they can't kill him. You understand me? So me don't have nobody for war. And the only competition that me could have get in our war.
So you
now.
Teach him generalship? Are you telling me generalship?
You have to tell me something.
Your son, man,
experience teaches wisdom, you know?
Yeah.
Why me no clash Cape Town? Who if you go up and say the Cape Town? Me and him 50-50 till the day. The show now go done. When me I do it smart lyrics. Me can't bother with a long bag of DJ there, because I too will get forward till tomorrow morning. Me no in that. Mm-hmm. Me kill people right away, boom, boom. I saw me did my thing. So there are certain war where you choose.
So your performance at Sting will be?
I'm performing for the people.
Okay.
I never do a show at Sting yet. And this is my first year going to give the people a performance. I look into him go harder than Sumfest. Sumfest was a warm-up. Mm-hmm. Right now, we are coming out to make the people say, Ninja Man is a stage show artist, a performing artist, and a recording artist. I've been years, 26 years, just doing, mashing up people's stage show. Now I'm doing shows. I don't need no one around me. I need to perform for the people, them. Because you know why?
Yeah.
If it wasn't for the fans, them, I would not be Ninja Man. I would only be Dead Man, yes. So to them, me give the thanks, well, then.
Ninja, can I cut you? Can I ask you to stay a moment or two? We're going to try to bring up a performance with the Prophet.
Mm-hmm.
And this is no clash. This is, if you will, sir, we will give you the stage for a minute.
Yeah, man, the Prophet can take on stage and show us, we not have no sense.
Okay. All right, sir. So we won't say goodbye right here. What we're going to do is take a break right here when we come back live right here on stage.
The Clutch Prophet, and Gear.
The Prophet and the Ninja.
We're it's not the Prophet and the Ninja. It's Clutch and Gear. We not have no stop.
Okay.
You take a break, we are Clutch and Gear.
I take a break. Clutch and Gear, the Ninja and the Prophet, will be right here on this stage. We'll be back.
Rockstone was my pillar, could not find place for sleep. But them empty, we have to find food for eat. Every day we terrorize.